Good morning, children. Welcome back to your biology class. We started our new chapter, Conservation of Plants and Animals, and we discussed a new topic, deforestation, in our previous class. So before going to a new topic, let's recall what we have discussed in the last class. We discussed about deforestation. Did you read the textbook? I hope you read. So what does mean by deforestation? It is actually clearing of forest by cutting the trees, isn't it? So what are the causes of deforestation? It's mainly by human activities and some natural causes also, like drought and forest fire. How does it affect our environment? It has so many consequences, like increase of carbon dioxide, global warming, then lowering of groundwater level, soil erosion, desertification, etc. Today, let us discuss about forest. Did you visit any forest? In Kerala, so many forest areas are there, isn't it? Silent Valley, Parambikulam, Idukki, Wayanad. I also visited forest areas as a part of my study too. So if you got a chance, you will definitely visit forest, because you will understand what type of ecosystem it is. Okay, so what's mean by an ecosystem? Forest is an ecosystem, isn't it? So what does mean by an ecosystem? An ecosystem consists of living things and non-living things. Living things means plants, animals and microorganisms. Non-living things means soil, water, sunlight. All these are non-living things. So the interaction of these living things with the non-living things make an ecosystem possible. The forests are considered as biodiversity hotspots because large number of life forms are found there. As I mentioned earlier, microorganisms, plants, animals, etc. So the plants and animals found in a particular area are termed as flora and fauna of that area. Some of these plants and animals are called as endemic species. The plants and animals which are seen exclusively in a particular area is called as endemic species. For example, lion-tailed macaque. These type of monkeys are only found in Silent Valley. Nilgiri tar, another example. It is only found in Munnar, Idukki. Okay, children, forests are the region with large biodiversity of endangered species. So what is mean by endangered species? Endangered species means their number is diminishing to a level that they might face extinction in near come future. Children, you don't get confused by these two terms, endemic species and endangered species. Endemic species are those species of plants and animals which are found exclusively in a particular area. They are not naturally found anywhere else. You can see Nilgiri tar in this picture. And this type is only found in Aravikulam National Park. Animals or plants whose numbers are diminishing to a level that they might face extinction are known as endangered species. Tiger is an example for endangered species in India. So Project Tiger was launched by the government to protect the tigers in the country. The objective of this project was to ensure the survival and maintenance of the tiger population in the country. Children, do you know why do their numbers are decreasing day by day? You know, children, all animals are freely and happily living in their natural habitat. But the survival of some animals has become difficult because of the disturbance in their natural habitat. It is mainly because of the human activities. So, government take actions to protect the plants and animals. I will show some name boards now. Read the name board, okay? Wayanad Wildlife Sanctuary, Iravikulam National Park,
Agastyamala Biosphere Reserve.
What are the differences between these sanctuaries, national park and biosphere reserves?
National parks, sanctuaries and biosphere reserves have been earmarked to protect our flora and fauna in their natural habitats. Plantation, cultivation, grazing, felling trees, hunting and poaching are prohibited in these areas. But there are slight variations in their functions. Let us discuss about them. Biosphere reserves. These are the large areas of protected land for the conservation of wildlife, plant and animal resources, and traditional life of the tribals living in the area. The biosphere reserves help to maintain the biodiversity and culture of that area. A biosphere reserve may also contain other protected areas in it. Nilgiri and Agastyamala are the examples of biosphere reserves in Kerala. Wildlife sanctuaries. Wildlife sanctuaries provide protection and suitable living conditions to wild animals. Sanctuaries are the places where killing or capturing of animals is strictly prohibited. Periyar, Neyyar, Pichi Varani, Parambikulam, Muthanya are the examples of wildlife sanctuaries in Kerala. The third one is National Park. National parks are large and diverse enough to protect whole set of ecosystems. They preserve flora, fauna, landscape and historic objects of an area. Irabikulam, Silent Valley are the examples of national parks in Kerala.
Thank you for listening me children. I already attached one YouTube URL, notes and test questions. Attend the test questions, download the notes and learn, and watch the animation with the help of that URL. Okay. See you next class with another topic. Till then, bye.